Let's see how to organize tasks and workflows. When inside an experiment card, you will see the option to Edit Experiment, where you can create and edit tasks and workflows, and the Actions button, where you can manage this experiment card. We cover these in other video tutorials. The Zoom options allow you to switch between the different task card views. You can also click on this location icon in the navigation panel to help you find the task you are looking for. To expand the canvas view, you can hide this navigation panel. Let's see what information we can find on a task card. Every task card has a name. Here we can check when the due date is. If a task is overdue, the date will be in a red. If it is due soon, the date will be orange. And if it is due in more than 24 hours, it will be in black. If it hasn't been set yet, we can add it. We can also change the existing due date. If a task has been completed, the date will show when it was completed. This cannot be modified. The status shows us how far along we are with a particular task. This is a depiction of the task status flow. A task can go back and forth between the not started, in progress, completed, in review, and done. The last two are only available to the premium users who have plans that include electronic signatures. Let's take a look at how to add a due date. I will set one for yesterday, one for today, and then one for tomorrow, and then just click Save again. This avatar icon is where we can assign people to tasks. Click Manage Users and select the people you want to assign from the drop-down menu. We can only assign those people to this task that have been added to this project. If one is assigned to a task, this is reflected on their personal dashboard under the Overview tab. Assigning users feature is there to help you delegate work. However, it does not affect who can edit a particular task. Editing rights depend on the user role a person got for this particular project. In other words, if you are, say, a technician on this project, you will be able to work with this task even if you are not assigned to it. Next, let's take a look at task activities. To view these, click here. For more information on activities, please watch our video tutorial on activities. Lastly, you can leave comments on a task card. Don't forget you can use smart annotations here. The @ symbol to tag people and the # symbol to tag other projects, experiments, tasks, or inventory items. You can also color code your task cards by using tags. Please keep in mind that tags are project specific. To add a tag, click here. Click the New button and on the pencil to change the name and the color. When you're happy with the tag, click here. If you have created some tags in this project already, you can select it from this drop-down menu and add it to this task card. You can use tags to further granulate your work, or to just add certain colorful reminders to tasks. For example, where an experiment should be conducted, under a hood, or use gloves, etc. If you go with your mouse over the tags, you'll be able to read the tags without clicking on them. To learn even more about Cynote, check the links in the description below.